Good evening, everybody. Good evening, and welcome to yet another super cool, super awesome, and absolutely amazing class on Heredity and Evolution, episode 5. We are going to discuss about the mono hybrid crows. Okay, can you all hear me? Is my audio audible for everybody? Okay, without wasting our time, let's move with the class. So here we have genetics episode 5. So here we have the super cool and rocking batch of BioPoint juniors. This was a slide last day we talked about, right? Was this a slide? We started last class with this slide, right? Yes. So I'm starting the class. Pisam Sataivam or Garden Pea. Guys, before 5 minutes of the ending of the class, I have to tell you something about yesterday's exam. How was the results, everybody? And how was the questions? Fast? How was the questions and how was the results? Did you all get the expected marks or below or above the marks you expected? Don't worry, those who haven't got your expected mark. Okay. No, nobody's performance is bad. Some students who joined late in the class just came to the last 5 position and the others did well. And I corrected the paper and I put the question, and the next test is being creating. We are creating. And guys, when do you want the next test? Tomorrow or day after tomorrow? Okay, one commented 25. Others, 25th July, you need the test. Ankit, tomorrow there are questions from monohybrid also, monohybrid, dihybrid crosses. Can we fix it on 25? Okay. Okay, I'll inform it about in the group. Okay. So what are the reasons? This is an important session. This is an important slide. What are the reasons why Mendel selected pea plants for his experiments? Because many varieties of pea were available. Peas are small plants and easy to grow. Peas can be self-fertilized and cross-fertilized. They have a short lifespan and can be studied in a small duration of time. I'm just recapping everything that we have studied in the last class about the 7 different traits that Mendel used in the experiment. Okay. Seed shape, seed color, pod shape, pod color, flower position, and plant size. So this was a slide that we have to explain today. Mendel's hybridization experiments. Ready for the class? Everybody, fast, be active. Okay. In the last class, we have 16 students and now only half students, 8. Okay, anyway, I'm continuing the class. Selection. Okay. Selection of 2 pea plants with contrasting characters. Then, yesterday also I have told, removal of anthers is known as emasculation. What are anthers? Anybody? Those who have seen my yesterday's class, those who were in my yesterday's live class must answer this. What do you mean by anther? Fast. It contains pollen and it is the male reproductive part of a flower. Okay, male reproductive part of a flower. In order to avoid self-pollination, that is self-deposition of the pollen grain. Look, this is a bisexual flower. That is, it is having both male and female part. Okay, both male and female parts are present on the same plant. That is called a bisexual. look, this is the male reproductive structure and these are the female reproductive structures. So what do you mean by avoiding your self-pollination? Avoiding your self-pollination means in order to prevent that self-deposition of these pollen grains into the stigma of the same plant, we just remove the stamens. Look, can you see in the image? Fast comment on the chat box. Can you see the anthers are removed? Can you all see the image? Look, this, it was attached to the plant and it was removed. And that process of removal of anthers is known as emasculation. Take down. Removal of anthers. Ritika, please mute yourself. Fast. Okay, thank you. Ritika, can you hear me now? Ritika, please comment. Can you hear me? Fast. Oh, no reply. Okay. Okay. Next is, look, the mental has selected the purple flower. Is it? Yes. Okay, Ritika. Is it the purple flower? Guys, is it the purple color appearing on the screen also? Yes. Okay, Mendel removed the male part of the plant from the purple flower and he selected the pollen grain from the white flower. If you take the purple flower is closed with the purple flower itself, the offsprings formed will also be purple. But in order to experiment that, he just removed the male reproductive part of the purple flower and he selected the male. He collected the pollen grains of a white colored flower of pea plant. See in the image 2? Is it visible everybody, this image 2? Collecting the stamens from the white flowers. Okay. Next, what he is doing is that the pollen which is collected from the white flower is transferred into the female reproductive part of the purple flower. Look, dusting of pollen grains collected from the white flower into the female reproductive part of the purple flower. And what was his observation at last? Even though he selected the pollen grain from the male parts, all progeny resulted in the formation of only how much? Purple flowers. Okay, progeny. Progeny means offspring. Progeny means offspring. Okay, since you are 10th standard students, you have to use this type of biological terms in your answers. Okay, progeny means offspring. Then next is collection of pollen grain from other male parent and is transferred into the parent, female parent. Then you have the collection and germination of seeds to produce the offspring. So we will discuss why only purple colored flowers are formed at the end, even though we use white color flowers. Guys, can we move in the next slide? Fast. I think you all are sleeping. Is it? Yeah, Bijit asked it out fast. Guys, if anybody have doubt in this hybridization experiment, ask me now itself. Hybridization means technique of producing new plants. Okay? Is it Raj, the new member who entered the class today? Is it him? Please reply. Rainish Raj. Is it Raj who entered the group today? Fast. Yeah, Aryan, we'll discuss about it in the monohybrid crosses. We have numerical part, that is mathematical solving in this part. Then only we can identify why only purple color were formed. Is it Raj over here? Please reply. Okay, this is a diagram. Okay. Hope you understood. You're understanding my class now. watch the previous lectures on YouTube. Okay. Okay, this is the image. If anybody wants to take the screenshot, take it fast. It will help you to understand. A flower is bisexual in nature, having both female and male reproductive part. We are removing the anthers. BioPoint. We'll provide the link on the group. Okay. BioPoint, stream the world of bio. Removing of anthers. Okay, removing of anther and filament. That is a male reproductive tract. Collecting pollen grain from another desired flower and is destined onto the stigma of the female flower for hybridization experiments. Very, very important class. Okay, very, very important. Before we start with this particular slide, then it will be easy for you to understand. Guys, ready with your notebook for doing the problems in biology for the first time? Ready, everybody? Max in biology. How many of you like Max? Or how many of you hate Max? The numericals, the trigonometry, then numbers, addition, subtraction, multiplication. Everybody like Max, so you will be able to study it. A new concept, okay? Biology and Max together in a class. You have problems in physics, problems in chemistry, then now problems in biology also. Okay, guys, what do you mean by mono? What is the meaning of the term mono? Simply, what do you mean by mono? Yes, single. So mono hybrid cross means a cross involving two plants. Okay, all the cross involves two different plants, which we are differing only one character, or we are taking only one character. We have studied seven characters of pea plant, right? Tell me one by one, guys, fast. Seven characters of pea plant. Fast, one by one, everybody. Yes, size of the plant, tall or dwarf. Yes, color of what? We have studied two color. Yes, height of plant, color of seed. We have studied color of pod. We have studied. Yes, seed shape. We have studied. Flower position. We have studied. Okay, all the seven characters that we discussed in yesterday's class, we are taking only one character. If you are taking plant height, we'll be taking tall plant and a dwarf plant. Okay. But in dihybrid cross, we will be taking, if we are taking tall plant, another, we will be taking what? Flower, what? Plant with axial flower. We will be taking two characters at the same time. But in monohybrid cross, we will be taking only one character. Okay. We will be taking only one character. Clear with the definition for monohybrid cross? Any doubt, ask me now. Axial flower, I'll explain now. One second, I'll take the image. Who asked me the doubt? Aryan. Aryan, please look. Terminal flowers means the flower will be born at the tip of the plant. No further growth of plants. Clear? But in axial, flowers are born on the branches. The plant tends to grow, developing new branches and new flowers. Clear? Aryan? Abhijit, cross means we are taking two plants with different characters and we are hybridizing, or we are trying to make a new offspring. Okay, so that is all about hybrid, monohybrid cross. We are taking two plants with one contrasting pair of character. Then, let us check the first experiment. Mendel cross, pure, tall and pure dwarf or short, small t plants. Guys, what is the name that you will give for if an allele occurs as capital T, small t, if both the alleles are same, what term will you give it? Anybody, those who have opened the NCERT and read the textbook must answer this question. Or those who have listened carefully. Yes, very good, Abhijit, very good. It is homozygous. Homozygous. Remembering everybody? Homozygous. And what about capital T, small t? Capital T, small t, what is the term? Guys, no reply from anybody in the session. Are you understanding the session? Not homologous. Yes, small t stands for short and capital for tall. One dominant, one recessive, all those. Guys, if capital T and small t stands for homozygous, what does this stands for? Heterozygous. Anybody remembering the term? Heterozygous. Yes, heterozygous. So what did Mendel choose? Mendel chose pure tall, that is homozygous tall and homozygous dwarf. Look at the image. Is the image visible to everybody? This particular image, everybody? Can you all see it on your screen? Everybody? Okay. Look, Mendel selected two different plants. Very important, okay? Mendel selected two different plants. Look at the genotype. What is genotype? Anybody? What do you mean by genotype? Phenotype, we have discussed. What is genotype? From the term, genotype. Nobody knows. It's not the reproductive part, Ayush. Genotype I'm talking about. No, it's not the similar character. Oh, you guys are not refreshing your mind with the terms. Genotype and phenotype we have discussed. Genotype means, that's what I have to tell in the last 5 minutes about you're not remembering certain things, which even some of you have made mistake. I'll tell all those in the last 5 minutes. I wanted to see everybody, those who have written yesterday's exam. That's why you lost certain marks. Yes, Ankit, genotype is the genetic constitution of an organism. For yesterday's exam, most of you have not given me the perfect answer for a particular question. I'll tell the question at last. I explained the rules even to write the name. I'll tell. Genotype means the genetic constitution and phenotype means the physical appearance. Look, the plant is tall. It is a phenotype. The plant is dwarf. It is a phenotype. What we observe is the phenotype. And genotype means the genetic constitution. If it is homozygous tall, what is the genotype of the plant? Fast. Anybody can tell me the answer. Genotype of a plant which is homozygous tall or which is pure tall. Tell me fast. Shame if you don't tell the answer. Anybody know the answer? Yeah, homozygous tall, what would be the genotype? Absolutely correct, Ayush. It is capital T. Guys, I'm asking you genotype. Genotype means the genetic constitution. If I'm asking you what is the phenotype of the plant, you have to tell me either in sentence or words, you have to tell me it is tall or dwarf. And if I'm asking you about the genotype means the genetic constitution. You have to tell me about the gene. What is the genotype of the first plant? I'm asking you have to tell me capital T. New students, are you getting my point? A little bit difficult for you to understand. Where are new students? Raj, are you understanding the point? Okay. So capital G for the homozygous tall plant and small t for the homozygous dwarf plant. Clear up to here? Yes, small t if come together, it will be dwarf. Capital T will be dominant, and if at least one capital T is present also, the plant will be dominant. Okay, everybody, Abhijit, Ankit, Arjun, Ishika, everybody understood up to here? Okay, guys, now you'll see, if we are extracting a gamete from the pure plant, okay, first plant, okay, genotype means the genetic constitution of an organism. Genotype means the genetic constitution of an organism. Genotype, suppose if we are taking the character for tall, can see to be capital T. All these, how you represent genotype. If it is dwarf, you can see it is to be, I'm writing with a mouse, okay, in my system. That's why the pen is going somewhere. Okay, this is a genotype. Okay, I'll try to send the note in the group. Guys, is anybody taking the screenshot of the slide? Abhijit? Yes, please share it in the group, okay? Okay, thank you. This is a genotype. Aryan, is it okay now? What do you mean by genotype? Genotype means the gene arrangement, the arrangement of genes or the genetic constitution. Aryan, is it clear now? Okay. Guys, if you are looking at this, if you are taking a particular gamete means which is necessary for, or the cells which are responsible for reproduction. If you are taking a gamete from capital T, both are capital T, right? If you are asked to take the gamete, you have to split it. What would be the answer? One will be this capital T, another will be capital T. Clear how you are taking the gametes? If someone asks you to separate the gametes from a plant, you have to separate it like this in this chapter. Clear, everybody? Fast. Are you getting? Guys, is anybody having delay or any audio issues? Everybody is having any issue with my class? Any audio or video issue? Okay. I think someone has asked me about the, I don't know who asked me. It might be a network issue from your side, okay? It will be corrected within few minutes. You just wait in the class itself. Okay? Yes, Arjun, we'll be doing the numerical. This is a kind of numerical. We'll be having certain mathematical ratio. Okay, my audio is not clear. Somebody is saying. Guys, what about now? Is the audio clear? How is the audio? Is it clear than before? Everybody? Ritika, how is the audio now? Okay. So, if you are asked to find the gametes from a particular type of allele, what you would be seeing, you have to separate the two type of genes present in it. Guys, now tell me the gametes from small t. What are the gametes from small t? Or pure dwarf plant, what would be the gametes? Yes, both will be small t. What would be the gametes in capital T, small t? Capital T, small t. Yes, one will be capital T and other will be small t. While you are writing it for the exam, while you are writing in case of gametes, you have to encircle it. Only when you come into case of gametes, look, it is encircled. while you're writing any other things, you don't need to circle it. But while you're writing the gamete, you have to write the alphabet inside the circle only. Okay. I'm having a small bit of throat in bad sore throat. That's why the voice is getting higher and lower. Okay. A small bit of kind of fever, a throat infection. Continuous classes right from the morning. That's why. Okay. Okay. If you have any doubt, or if any issue with the audio, you can tell me. I'll try to increase the volume. No problem. Okay. Guys, clear with this slide. Clear. Any doubt you wanted to explain at least one point, you can tell me now itself. Up to here, clear. Up to here. Everybody. Okay. So next slide will be having the continuation of this thing. What do you mean by F1 generation? Guys, there are F1 generation and F2 generation. F1 means first filial generation. F-I-L-I-A-L. First filial generation. You have to study this. This is a CBSE board question. I think 2015 or 16, I don't remember the year correctly. 2015 or 16, this question was asked. In a monohybrid cross, we tell that F1 generation, only tall plants are formed. What does F1 represent? So your answer should be first filial generation. Everybody clear with the answer for the question? Ritika, clear? Ritika? Okay. So, guys, look. Your parent plant was T. And you have t. We are taking homozygous condition. Both plants are, or both parents are homozygous. Suppose this is male. Guys, do not write male and female. This is a symbol for male. And this is a symbol for female. Have you studied it before, these symbols? Have you studied these symbols before? Yes, some students have studied, some students have not studied. Please take note of this, okay? From today onwards, you have to write like this. This is a male parent, okay? This is the male parent. So male parent is represented by this symbol. T. The female parent is t. Guys, it is not compulsory that you have to take T as the male. I am just taking, for my convenience, I am taking it as male and the other female. When you are doing it, you can take the first as female and the second one as male only. Okay, we have only 10 minutes. I have to finish the monohybrid cross today. Abhijit, clear? Okay. It is the parent, okay? Male parent having T, female parent having t. Next step is, first when you're asked to do the cross, you have to first write parent. Then you have to write these two things. Then the second stage is you have to write gamete. Split it into two. Here only one type of gametes will be formed. Write only T. Am I clear? To everybody? Even though there are two type of alleles, that is T, and when we are splitting it, only similar type of gamete will be formed, that is T only, right? So I am writing only one, T. And from here you will be getting t. And this is possible. Only one type of gamete is formed in case of homozygous condition. Only in case of homozygous condition. Okay. While in heterozygous condition, that is capital T, small t, two gametes formed are different. One is capital T and other is small t. Okay. Okay, everybody. Okay, now we are going to cross it. Then you will be getting the F1 generation, the first generation you will be getting. Cross these two things. Capital T and small t, when crossed together, you will be getting the genotype of the plant will be, tell me fast, capital T. Yes, absolutely, capital T, small t. And what would be the term used to refer this condition? Term. What is the single term used to refer capital T, small t? Yes, heterozygous condition. Guys, instead of doing like this, you can do it with the help of a checkerboard. It is known as checkerboard. Or you can call it to be Puret square. Or you can call it to be as Puret square. Okay, because when you come into higher crosses, when you're asked to do the higher crosses, you will get confused. I will show you how you will be obtaining this capital T, small t with okay. Yeah, I'm going to explain once again. The parent. Okay. Can you see my screen, everybody? The parent, male parent will be capital T, capital T. And the female parent will be small t, small t. Tell me the two type of gamete obtained from this parent, male parent. It will be capital T, capital T. And here you will be having small t, small t. Yes, absolutely. And that is the gametes. Then you have to calculate the F1 generation. Or the first filial generation. This you can either do like this. Capital T crossed with the capital T. What would be the result? What is the result of the cross? Capital T. Yes, absolutely. Capital T, small t. When you are crossing this with this, what would be the result? Yes, capital T, small t. These two gametes, again capital T, small t. These two gametes, again the same, absolutely correct. Capital T, small t. So these, all the plants formed in the F1 generations are tall plants. Is it? All the plants are tall, right? Everybody? Yes. Even though we took tall parent and dwarf parent, the allele that gets transformed into the offspring is only dominant allele. Clear? Clear? I'll explain the same thing with the help of checkerboard also. In checkerboard, how we are going to do is, you'll be drawing a box. Yes, only dominant character predominates in the offspring. You will be drawing a board. This is a monohybrid cross, right? This is a monohybrid cross, so you need four boxes. How many boxes you need? Four. Guys, are you getting me at the point I'm telling? Yes. We need four boxes since it is a monohybrid cross. We have to represent in the this axis, you have to represent either the male or the female. If you are representing male parent over here, you can represent the female parent in this direction. Okay. What are the gametes of the male parent? This is a male parent. What are the gametes? Capital T, capital T. So you can write over in the top of each box, capital T, capital T. And for the female parent, you have small t, small t. Then you can make the cross. Capital T, small t. What would be the answer? T, T. Capital T, small t. T, T. Capital T, small t again. Capital T, small t. So all the plants, if you are sometimes in the question paper, you can see, explain with the help of Punnett square or checkerboard. Then if you do the cross like this, you won't get marks. Even though the answer, you get the answer correctly, you won't, the examiner will not give you the marks. If they are asking you right, the Punnett square, or explain it with the help of a Punnett square, you will be getting marks for this only. Up to here, is it clear, everybody? Any doubt, you can ask now. Ankit, is it same? Sorry, is it clear? Ankit, yes. Ritika, is it clear? Okay, guys. So I am winding in the class over here. We have only 2 minutes remaining. And I have to tell you one thing. Yes, only 1 minute remaining. Guys, when I corrected the papers yesterday, guys, how was the question for the exam? Was it very, very simple? Yes, it was simple question. Right? If you have studied it, that I wanted to score good marks, and if a person studied it with such a will, you might score full marks for the exam. No doubt for that. But I find when I corrected or when I gone through everybody's paper, the common thing that I have to tell everybody is that most of you are just reading and studying everything. You're thinking that biology is a very easy subject. Yes, biology is an easy subject. Guys, I'm not scolding you. I'm making you understand. Any problem? Are you feeling that I'm scolding you? I'm just telling, okay, in order to improve in the next exam. Many of you haven't wrote and studied, because I found almost yesterday 13 students wrote the exam and almost 12 students made mistakes with the spellings. Deoxyribonucleic acid, you made the mistake in the spelling, so many students. Now our class will end. I'll continue with this in the next class. Okay, I have these things to explain to you. And the thing was that Pisam Sataivam, nobody have wrote the scientific name. Some students have wrote the scientific name, but not according to the rule. I told you that when you're writing a scientific name, you have to underline it separately.